I was jealous of Cromer's, you know.
His Eminence. Isn't that what you used to call him?
Well, that's what he was. Your leading cardinal. Your favorite son till I arrived on the scene.
He was a wonderful cellist.
He was a wonderful everything.
Far too wonderful.
Oh, I liked him.
I was terrified of him. When I started at the Institute, I was terrified of all of them. All the boy wonders you had here. They were all so brilliant and accomplished. But Cromer's was the heir apparent. The rest of us had to work in the general study hall. Cromer's had the private office next to yours.
Mm-hmm.
Like the electron on the inmost orbit around the nucleus.
Mm-hmm.
And he didn't think much of my physics. He insisted he could explain everything about the atom by classical mechanics.
Well, he was wrong.
Very soon, the private office was vacant.
And there was another electron on the inmost orbit.
And for 3 years, we lived inside the atom.
Yes, with other electrons on the outer orbits around us, all over Europe.
Max Born and Pascual Jordan in Göttingen.
Schrödinger in Zurich, Fermi in Rome.
Chadwick and Dirac in England.
Joliot and de Broglie in Paris.
Gamow and Landau in Russia.
Everyone in and out of each other's departments.
Papers and drafts of papers on every international mail train.
You remember when Hauschmidt and Uhlenbeck did spin?
There's this one last variable in the quantum state of the atom that no one can make sense of. The last hurdle.
And these two crazy Dutchmen go back to a ridiculous idea that electrons can spin in different ways.
And, of course, the first thing everyone wants to know is what line is Copenhagen going to take?
I'm on my way to Leiden, as it happens.
And it turns into a papal progress. The train stops on the way in Hamburg.
And Pauli and Stern are waiting on the platform to ask me what I think about spin.
You tell them it's wrong.
No. I tell them it's very...
interesting?
I think that's precisely the word I choose.
Then the train pulls into Leiden.
And I'm met at the barrier by Einstein and Ehrenfest. And I change my mind. Because Einstein, you see. I'm the Pope. He's God. Because Einstein has made a relativistic analysis and it resolves all my doubts.
Meanwhile, I'm standing in for Max Born in Göttingen, so you make a detour there on your way home.
And you and Jordan meet me at the station.
Same question. What do you think of spin?
And when the train stops at Berlin... there's Pauli on the platform.
Wolfgang Pauli, who never gets out of bed if he can possibly avoid it.
Who's already met me once at Hamburg on the journey out.
He traveled all the way from Hamburg to Berlin purely in order to see you for the second time round.
And find out how my ideas on spin have developed en route.
Oh, those years. Those amazing years.
Mm.
Those 3 short years.
1924 to 1927.
From when I arrived in Copenhagen to work with you.
To when you departed to take up your chair at Leipzig.
3 years of raw, bracing northern springtime.
At the end of which, we had quantum mechanics. Mm. We had uncertainty.
We had complementarity.
We had the whole Copenhagen interpretation.